A donation to cool a hot classroom could be the first of its kind for a Hawaii school. RevoluSun is donating a solar-powered air conditioning system to Kalaheo High School in Kailua. This comes at a time when Hawaii is reporting record-breaking heat. Other schools are receiving fans, and the DOE is installing portable air conditioners in some classrooms. Christine Ueno has been tracking the issue and follows through. Chris?
Joe, if all goes well, the solar-powered AC unit will be installed at no charge, work off the grid, and would not increase the power bill. RevoluSun and school officials hope this can serve as a pilot project.
Like other schools in the state, Kalaheo High School has been unbearably hot. That's according to its principal, who doesn't know exactly how hot.
But I will tell you that it must be approaching the triple digits some days.
So one of the lawmakers in that district, Representative Cynthia Thielen, called locally owned company RevoluSun and asked,
"Could you help us with Kalaheo, where the students are just so incredibly hot they're not even able to learn?"
RevoluSun agreed, offering a solar-powered air conditioner for one of the rooms. It's valued at $10,000.
How does it work in terms of infrastructure? Do improvements need to be made?
No, it shouldn't be any major improvements to schools or houses where these things would be placed. A solar off-grid air conditioning unit is a self-contained thing.
RevoluSun is also planning to donate batteries, which could store power to help on cloudy days.
I asked the DOE about the donation, and a spokesperson says the state is grateful, but is still working with RevoluSun on the feasibility of the system.
We can simply, you know, put it on the roof, put some panels on the roof, and hook it into the solar AC equipment, and that'll provide cooling for the classroom.
The DOE has said it's working vigorously to address the heat situation in schools and bought portable ACs and delivered fans.
Do you think that's a good idea, or they should spend their money someplace else?
I think the better idea is to spend money on the standalone systems that don't add money to the utility bill for that school.
I'm hopeful that maybe through this pilot there might be more knowledge gained, and hey, who knows, maybe some more systems that might be coming to the schools in Hawaii.
RevoluSun will visit Kalaheo tomorrow to take a look at the site and determine which class might receive the AC. The company will also meet with the DOE later this week to go over details. If it works out, RevoluSun says it could install that system within a month. We'll keep you posted. Christine Ueno, KHON2 News.